Hello, my name is Thomas. I play the cello in the symphony. Before we hear more cello music, let me tell you how I got here. I was born in Germany, very close to the Dutch border. In fact, many of my music teachers came from Holland. But I better start from the beginning. At a very young age, I was playing around with musical instruments, the harmonica and my drums. At the age of 6, I joined our music school, where I learned how to read music and play all different sizes of recorders. 2 years later, I started on the violin. I soon was part of a string orchestra. That's where I saw a cello for the first time. I had to try it. Once I decided to become a musician, I added the piano and a little later the church organ. It was a very exciting time because it became easier with each new instrument. Once you can read music and know your instrument, you're ready to join various music ensembles. Every year we gave many concerts with our school choir. I accompanied a choir on a long tour across the United States and played piano trio in period costumes. Other fun groups were our Salon Music Ensemble and Stage Orchestra. Even our barbershop quartet enjoyed many performances. There was no question that music was going to be a big part of my life. My formal education took me to Hanover, where I studied music education at the University for Music and Theater, and also mathematics at the Leibniz University. Since both universities were far apart, I had to use my bicycle a lot during those times. I was ready for an even bigger adventure, the United States of America. My first destination was Miami, Florida. There, I studied cello performance at the Frost School of Music, which is part of the University of Miami. My second destination was Beaumont, Texas, home of the Symphony of Southeast Texas. The bowed string instruments form the largest section in the orchestra. They are seated closest to the audience. On the left side, we have the massive first and second violin section. The viola section form the orchestra's right center. The cello section sits opposite the violins to the right of the conductor. Well, you can't miss the bass section on the far right. Let's check out my favorite section, the cello section. Whoa, this picture is way too colorful. Let's remove some of it so we can focus on the musicians. Okay, that's better. Well, I almost forgot about the names. Here they are. So, the next time you come to listen to the orchestra, you know who is playing the cello. Let us look at a famous piece called Frere Jacques or Brother Jacob. Being around, this piece can be played simultaneously with itself, time-shifted by two measures. Now, that sounds complicated, but let me play the melody first. I'm sure you've heard it before. We can now use that simple melody and create a musical round. The first cello starts the song, followed by the second, then the third, and finally the fourth. Each cello starts the song from the beginning, as shown by the blue color, then continues the song. Using technology, in this case a simple iPad, we can now create entire ensembles using a single musician. How cool is that?